Some time ago, I showed you why I ditched Chrome, and I'm using Microsoft Edge now as my daily internet browser. Now, there was a lot of feedback, which I really appreciate. Now, some great tips can be found in the comments of that video. So I decided to share some of the highlights and my personal favorites in Edge. Now, I'm sure you're going to find something useful here. Now, if I had to rank these, my favorite would be number 6. I wonder what yours is. So as you're watching, comment below and let me know. Number 1, organize your ideas with collections. In Edge, you're going to see this little plus button for collections. You can also use the shortcut Ctrl+Shift+Y. In my case, I don't have any collections yet. So I'm just going to rename this new collection up here. Let's say I'm finally planning a trip and I already researched some great locations. I can easily add these websites to my collection by clicking on Add Current Page, or just add the links to the website. Just drag them over like this. Or let's say I found this list of highlights to check out in the area. I can just highlight the text and drag it into my collection. I can also add an image, like this one, to get inspiration for a photo shoot. You can also add a quick note to remind yourself. So let's say I don't want to forget to look up travel insurance, because in times like this, you never know. If you want to reorder your items, just drag and drop. To delete something from the collection, right-click on the item and select Delete. You can create as many collections for different topics as you want. Just click the back button on your current collection and select Start New Collection. A couple of nice features are hidden behind the ellipses menu. When you click on the three dots, you'll get to more options. For example, you can export and save your collection to Excel, OneNote, Word, or even to Pinterest. Another cool feature is to open all items in your collection in a new window as separate new tabs. Very convenient. You can easily share your collection with others as well. Click on the ellipses and select Copy All, then paste the cards into an email or in a Teams message. Number 2, read and annotate PDF files. Like most browsers, Microsoft Edge comes with a built-in PDF reader. But with Edge, you can also annotate these files with ink and highlighting. And there are also a couple of other nice features. Let me show you. Here, I have a PDF document open in Edge. With the drop-down next to Draw, you can select the ink properties, like color and thickness. Then just make your annotations. With the Highlight tool, you can easily highlight important text. Use the drop-down to change the color. You can also add comments. Highlight some text, which is going to bring up this window. Select Add Comment and type in your comment. When you're done, click on Save, and you're going to see the comment in the PDF. But there's even more. Over here on the left, you'll see Contents. If the PDF was created with bookmarks, you can display the table of contents. This way you can easily navigate in the document. I always recommend adding bookmarks for PDF files. I have a separate video on this. Check it out. I'm going to add the link to the description. With Read Aloud, you can let Edge read the PDF document to you. This works for all true PDF files, but not for scanned PDFs. In the better version of Edge, you can select natural voices from the voice options. They'll be available for everyone soon. Here's an example.
2.5, the sort and sort by functions.
With Page View, you can change from single page to two page view. This way you can read your PDF in a book type of layout. Number 3, create web apps. Microsoft Edge allows you to create a web app for the websites that you visit. I use this for a few websites that I access every day that don't have apps. Now this allows you to open the pages directly from your desktop without having to open your browser. To create a web app, open the website. For my example, I'm going to use Excel Plus. Then click on the ellipses in the upper right corner and select Apps, and then install this site as an app. You can edit the name. I'm just going to go with Excel Plus, then click on Install. Once completed, the tab is going to close and the Excel Plus web app will open in a new window. You can pin it to your taskbar, or you can just launch it from the Start menu. To uninstall any of these apps that you created, just click on the ellipses and select Apps, and then click on Manage Apps. Uninstall the app by clicking the X and then select Remove. Number 4, QR code generator. Did you know that Edge has a built-in QR code generator? This way you can easily share a website. So let's say I'm on this page and I want to share this tutorial. If I click in the address bar, I get this icon to create a QR code. When I click it, it generates the QR code for me. No more add-ins or extensions are necessary. Now you can take a screenshot of the QR code or download it as a PNG file. Number 5, capture and annotate the web. With the new web capture feature, you can create and annotate screenshots. So let's say I have this tutorial here. It's pretty long and I want to screenshot this. You can either click on the ellipses and select web capture, or you can use the shortcut Ctrl+Shift+S. This is going to bring up this little toolbar here. You can either capture a certain area like this, or if you want, you can create a screenshot of the full page. And that's it. Now you have a scrollable screenshot of the entire page. You can annotate this as you need with the pen tool. When you're done, save it, copy it, or just share it with others. Pretty neat, right? Number 6, multi-user functionality with profiles. Profiles in Edge are godsend for me because I'm accessing different work accounts every day. Now, with this multi-user functionality, switching between them is really easy, but it's also a great way to keep your favorites and your login environments for work and private separate. So let me show you. In the upper right corner, you see your icon. Click it to get to your profile settings. I have two profiles set up for me. If I click on the second one, it opens up a separate instance of Edge with the favorites, add-ins, and logins that I created with this profile. So this way I can keep my private profile completely separate from my work environment, and I don't have to keep logging out and logging back in. The profiles will maintain their logins. I just have to switch my profile. To set up a new profile, just click the plus down here. Super convenient. Number 7, Math Solver. Now, this new feature allows you to solve math problems using your browser. Here's how. Click on the ellipses and select Settings. Click on Appearance, and down here, you're going to see Show Math Solver button. When you turn it on, you'll see this little Math Solver button up here. Now, we're ready to test it. Let's say I have this math challenge that I need some help with. Click on the Math Solver button and then drag it around the math problem. In my case, it's this one. Then click on Solve. It uses OCR to read the equation, and in case it didn't pick it up perfectly, you can use the math keyboard here to adjust it. But in my case, it picked it up great. And not only does it solve, but it also shows the solution steps. If you scroll down, it will also recommend some videos and additional learning content. So next time, you can hopefully solve it yourself. Number 8, Browser Task Manager. What do you do when your browser becomes slow or unresponsive? Now you might think it's just one of the pages that you're loading, or maybe it's a new extension that you just installed. How do you find out what's really going on? An easy way is to use the Browser Task Manager. That's right, Edge got its own task manager. To get to it, click on the ellipses, then More Tools, and then select Browser Task Manager. An easier way is to use the shortcut Shift and Escape. When the window opens, you're going to see a list of all tabs, processes, and extensions that are running in your browser. And for each one, you see how much system memory, CPU capacity, and network bandwidth it's using. And if a tab or an extension becomes unresponsive, you can force it to close. Just select it and then click on End Process. Number 9, group your tabs. If you're like me and you're often browsing with a lot of tabs, it can quickly get out of hand. Edge has now a feature called Tab Groups that helps you stay organized. This is currently still in preview, so we'll have to enable it first. Open your browser and type in Edge colon flags. This takes us to the page where we can enable experimental features. Type in tab group in the search bar, and it's the first one here. Enable it with this dropdown. Then click on restart to activate it. So now when you right click on a tab, you get the option to add the tab to a new group. Let's select this, and now we can give the group a name, and select a color for it. Let's add another tab to this group. Right-click and select Add Tab to Group. And now this new group we created shows up here. Let's add it to the same group. And I'll add the next tab here as well. This time, I'll just drag the tab into the group. And now I can easily group and expand the tabs. And of course, you can create several of these groups to organize yourself. This also works great in combination with vertical tabs. So when I turn on vertical tabs, you'll now get these nice sections that you can expand and close. Number 10, friendly URL. Last tip is a quick one for pasting URLs. Usually, when you copy an address from your browser and you paste it to Teams or Outlook, you'll get the whole long URL. But when you copy the address from Edge and paste it, it's going to insert the page name instead. The link is, of course, there. It's just much neater this way. I became a big fan of Edge, and I hope you found some new features here that you can apply to your daily web browsing. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up, and do consider joining our community by subscribing if you haven't already done so. Many thanks for watching, and I'm going to see you in the next video.